Hello friends, welcome all. I'm Daniel Fonsajos. Today we are going to discuss about employee participation in management. Employee participation in the management is regarded as the most acceptable principle of industrial relations in the modern industry, not only in India, but other countries of the world as well. In any type of organization, it is a complex process. So, what is workers' participation in management? It is a process by which the subordinates or employees either individually or collectively become involved in one or more aspects of the organizational decision making within the enterprise in which they work. Simply, workers' participation in management refers to the participation of non-managerial employees in the decision making process of the organization. Employees usually participate through their group representatives. The nature and the extent of participation depends upon the nature of the organization or the nature of different problems which need solution. The thing which is to be noted that this concept was designed to give human touch to management activities, which means a mental and emotional involvement of workers in the participation in the management of the organization. Then here is the definition which is given by Kate Davis. Participation is a mental and emotional involvement of a person in a group situation which encourages to contribute to group goals or objectives and share responsibilities. This definition explains three important elements of participation, which are: it means a mental and emotional involvement rather than mere physical activity. Next one, participation must motivate a person to contribute his own resources such as initiative, knowledge, creativity, etc. It encourages people to share responsibility for a decision or activity. Then the objectives of employee participation in management are different in various countries, states, cities, regions and organizations. When employees are encouraged to participate, it is vital to take into account the areas in which they would participate. This depends on number of factors such as quality of human resources, level of technology, materials, equipment and tools, level of competition and overall working environmental conditions, etc. The common objectives are to prevent workers from exploitation by the management or by the owners of the organization, to have democracy in the organization, to have proper development of working class, to create in employees a sense of participation in industry, to encourage suggestions from employees, to give employees an opportunity for self-expression, to promote better understanding between labors and management, to improve working and living conditions of employees. The next, we are going to discuss about various techniques or forms of employee participation in management. First one is Works Committee. The Works Committee started in India because of the Industrial Disputes Act 1947. Section 3 of the Act provides for the constitution of Works Committee. The objectives of Works Committee is to create a cordial relations between the management and the workers. That means the main purpose of creating Works Committee in an organization is to develop a sense of partnership between the employee and his workmen. It is a committee consisting of representatives from both employees and the employers. It is prescribed that Works Committee should be constituted in every industrial establishment employing 100 or more workers. Then, which are the functions of Works Committee? To act as a direct link and means of communication between management and employees at shop level, to provide means of representation and discussion with management of employees' requirements and grievances, to promote productivity by generating stable and healthy atmosphere within the company and especially within the working environment, to promote the interest of employees, to elect some of its members to represent employees on the Works Council. The next one is Joint Management Council. This council was set up as early as 1958. This council consists of equal number of representatives of the employers and employees, not exceeding 12 at the plant level. The council discusses various matters relating to working of the industry. Here are the objectives and criteria for setting up of Joint Management Council. First, objectives: to promote cordial industry relations, to promote operational efficiency of workers, to promote welfare facilities to workers, to educate and prepare workers for meaningful participation in organizational matters. Then criteria for setting up. The unit must have 500 or more workers. It should have fair record of industrial relations. The organization should have well-defined trade union affiliated to one of the central federations. Both management and workers should agree to setting up of such a unit. Next technique is joint counsel. It is said that at every division or department or branch or employing 100 or more people, there shall be a joint counsel. Every organization shall decide the number of councils to be set up for different departments or services rendered in consultation with the recognized union or workers. Only those who are actually engaged in the organization or services shall be the member of joint council. The tenure of the council shall be 2 years. If, however, a member is nominated in the midterm of the council to fill a casual vacancy, the member nominator shall continue in the office for the remaining period of the council's tenure. The chief executive of the organization or the divisional or regional branch, as the case may be, the chairman of the joint council. The joint council shall meet whenever considered necessary, but at least once in a quarter. The joint council shall appoint one of its members as its secretary, who will prepare the agenda, record the minutes of meeting, and report on the implementation of decisions arrived at every meeting. Every decisions of the joint council shall be binding on the management and the workers and shall be implemented within 1 month, unless otherwise stated in the decision. Here are some of the functions of joint council. The joint councils are concerned with the matters relating to unit councils. The joint council shall review and settle issues which are not settled by the unit councils. It also related to the development of skills of workers, improvement of working condition, preparation of schedules of working hours and holidays, recognition and appreciation of suggestions received from the workers, discuss the matters relating to improvement of performance of the organization, etc. Then another form is unit council. This scheme was announced on 5th January 1977. The unit council shall have representatives of workers and management for organizations having employing 100 or more workers. These unit councils are formed to discuss the day-to-day problems and solutions. But whenever necessary, a composite council may be formed to serve more than one unit, or a unit may be formed department-wise to suit the particular needs of the organization or service. Every unit shall consist of equal number of representatives of workers and the management. The actual number of members should be determined by the management in consultation with the recognized union. The total number of members may not exceed 12. The chairman of the council shall be the nominee of the management. The worker member of the council shall elect a vice chairman from among themselves. Every decision of the unit council shall be implemented by the parties concerned within a month unless otherwise stated in the decision itself. The management shall make suitable arrangements for the recording and maintenance of the minutes of meeting and designate one of its representatives as a secretary for this purpose, who shall also report on the actions taken on the decisions and the subsequent meetings of the council. A council once formed shall function for a period of 3 years. Also, any member nominated or elected to the council in the midterm to fill a casual vacancy shall continue to be the member of the council for the unexpired period of the term of the council. The council shall meet as frequently as is necessary, but at least once in a month. Here the functions: to create conditions for maximum efficiency and better customer service, to identify the areas of inferior service and take actions to eliminate them, to study absenteeism problems and take steps to reduce it, to ensure proper flow of communication between management and workers, to recommend and improve safety, health and welfare measures, etc. Plan Council is applicable to all the central public sector undertakings except those which are given specific exceptions from the operations of the scheme by the government. The number of members of each plan council shall not be less than 6 and not more than 18. The council shall have a tenure shall have a tenure of a period of 3 years. They shall meet once in a quarter. The decisions of the council shall be implemented within a month unless otherwise stated in the decision itself. The council deals with the operational areas, economic matters, financial aspects, personal matters and welfare and economic matters. These are explained here. Personal matters includes matters relating to absenteeism, special problems of women workers, initiation and administration of workers' programs. Welfare areas includes implementation of welfare schemes, medical benefits, housing and transportation facilities, safety measures, township administration, etc. Environmental areas includes environmental protection, extension activities and community development projects, etc. Operational areas includes determination of productivity schemes, planning, implementation and attainment of review of monthly targets and schedules, material supply and preventing its shortfall, housekeeping activities, review of working of shop level bodies, etc. Economic and financial aspects includes profit and loss statement, balance sheet, review of operating expenses, financial results and cost of sale, enterprise performance in financial terms, market conditions, etc. The next one is shop council. Every industrial unit employing 500 or more workers, the employees shall constitute a shop council. Shop council represents each department or a shop in a council. Each shop council consists of equal representatives of employers and workers. The employees' representation shall be nominated by the management, and the workers' representatives will be from among the workers themselves. Shop council shall not be, the members shall not be more than 12. A council once formed shall function for a period of 3 years. The council shall meet at least once in a month. The next one is workers' representation on board of management. Here, the workers' representative is given a seat on the board of directors. That is, one or two representatives of workers are nominated or elected to the board of directors. The basic idea is to safeguard the workers' interest and bring good relations between workers and management. This is the highest form of participation. Workers' participation on board shall be limited to companies which employ 1,000 or more workers. It does not include casual or badly workers. The employee representative or the worker director participate in all the functions of the board. Besides this, they also review the working of the shop and plan council and take decisions on matters not settled by the council. The workers who elected as director is given training in various important aspects of business, but this scheme failed to develop good relations based on trust, faith and understanding and cooperation, and also the scheme has not helped much in decision making. We know that the shareholders of the companies are the corporate owners. The shareholders consist of businessmen, traders, professionals, employees, workers, housewives, miners, institutions, associations, etc. This may be done. So workers may become the shareholders of the company. This may be done by inducing them to buy equity shares. So by virtue of their being shareholders, they have the right to participate in the management of the company. Shares of the company can be acquired by the workers making cash payment or by way of stock option schemes. The company may also advance loans or even given financial assistance to such workers to enable them to buy equity shares. Participation through ownership has the distinct advantage of making the workers committed to the job and to the organization, and it aims at improving industrial relations and a feeling of being together. So these all are the various forms or techniques of workers' participation in management. Hope you all understood it. Thank you.